All right, here we are. Welcome to my living room, my formal living room. And I went into the guitar vault and I took out all my Diamond guitars, my Diamond DBZ guitars. I had a live webcast last night and I wanted to share with you, we had Jeff Diamond, president and CEO of Diamond Guitars, Diamond Amplification on. And it inspired me to go get all of my Diamond guitars, put them on my couches, and I wanted to share with you the collection. So hopefully you enjoy this video. So this one here is a Bolero. It's basically their single cut design. And you could see it has a lot of nice curves, a lot of three-dimensional curves. And the fit and finish on the line is really just second to none. It's very three-dimensional. And it's just a gorgeous guitar. Matching headstock. This is an older headstock. I've had a relationship with the folks over there for, I want to say, about 10 years now. Maybe 8 years, 9 years, something like that. I have several different versions of the guitar line. Okay, so that's the Bolero in AB Plus. Okay, here's another Bolero. Very, very popular in the Siberian quilt. I actually showed this one on my video last night, and this is actually the actual wood grain on this one in particular is really one of my favorites here. It's just got such a nice, big, bold, almost boa constrictor style a grain pattern on here. And just a stunning guitar. Look at the natural scraped binding. Really just a beautiful guitar. Proud to have this one in the collection. Okay, so then if we come over here, we get into some fancy stuff. Well, not fancy, but maybe I should say retro stuff. A V, this one is called the Cavallo. This is a V, and this guitar is so light. It's made out of Carina, which is really exciting because it's I feel like it's a tribute to an original. Very light. Also three-dimensional. If you could catch the curves, there are curves in the lots of curves in the guitar itself, and that's something really just trademarked to the line. Got some nice Duncans in here. We have the jack plate actually recessed in the curves, which is done nicely. Gold hardware, and look at the gold on the truss rod cover. It's just such a classy looking guitar. I got this one from R&A Music. Thank you, Ryan. I remember seeing, I think you sent me either some pictures or videos of you packing it up, setting it up. Just gorgeous guitar, love this guitar. This one right here is the TTK2. This was a collaboration I did with friend and fellow rocker Jeff Diamond. And this one here is a TTK2. If you look at the headstock, you could see it says TTK on the first fret and the TTK2. I still have the plastic on it. It's really just a beautiful guitar. Red binding. See that nice red binding? And then the back, and this was actually Jeff's idea, was doing the burst neck finish. See how the neck is red and it has like a black, I guess it's a black burst on top of red. Just gorgeous guitar. Really, really beautiful guitar. Very, very proud of this one. And that, I think that may be either the first or the only, or maybe, I think it was the first Diamond guitar that came with the maple fretboard. See how the contrast of the lighter color wood on the darker body, the reverse headstock. It was really a throwback for me when we were designing this of an 80s gunslinger style guitar. Very proud of that guitar. Over here, we have a nice Imperial. This is, what I like about the Imperial is that it's not as big as a 335. It's kind of, maybe it's big like a 335, but it's not massive. It's not a big box guitar. In fact, if you notice, it's very thin. You see how thin that is? It's very, very thin. But look at the finish, that indigo finish. Gorgeous. And again, when you look at fit and finish, You know, even the tail pieces, it's just not stock run-of-the-mill stuff. Every detail in the line is really just done nicely. Matching truss rod cover on this one. Coincidentally, we have diamond inlays, a gorgeous 12th fret diamond inlay. And the thing I like is also the appointments of the, you know, that real thick, bold, scraped binding. It's just a gorgeous guitar. They really do it right. This one here is the Hailfire. It probably wasn't at first. You know, we all have our favorites, and at first the Bolero was my favorite. And then, of course, when the TTK2 came out, I loved that guitar, and then I got a Cavallo. So when I got this one, I liked this guitar, but I have to be honest with you. I think I have grown where this may be my favorite. It's got a very modern look, but on a retro design. This is like a Firebird style. And it's just, you know what, three-dimensional. You got one plateau, two plateau, three plateau. So you could see like the stair step design, even over here. One, two, three. Very three-dimensional. It's very light, very comfortable to play. I've been using this in some videos. And if you play on stage or if you make videos, a white guitar with black appointments, you know, sometimes less is more. And I really come to love and appreciate this guitar right here. Plus, it sounds amazing. It's got Duncans in here. It just sounds real nice. I have my volume and tone guitar strap. I think the presentation is just, you know, all there. Just a nice guitar. I also used this guitar in my outdoor PV Viper video. I'll include that link below for you guys to check out. That's the Hailfire. And then I have one more right over here. This one here is the Renegade. And once again, like the Imperial, very thin body, very lightweight, but very, very comfortable. And a lot of times people have asked me, is it too thin? Absolutely not. It's got a lot of girth because it's just the edges, it bevels out. But if you look inside, like where the pickups are, it's actually got a big chunk of meat right in the middle of the guitar. I don't know if you could kind of see it like that, but it's beveled out, but you got a lot of meat where you need the meat, but it's just such a nice bevel out. It's just really I'll be honest with you, there's nothing else like this guitar, even the Imperial in terms of the curves, okay? Nice block inlays, a nice gold stripe on like, you know, a nice galaxy black or an obsidian black. Just, it's almost like a metallic black. I don't know, let's see if we could get the metallic black in the lighting. Can you see that metallic black in there? Is it coming out in the camera? Good. And also, again, fit and finish, a lot of manufacturers will cut corners. You know, and they don't, because if you go to the headstock, you could see they continued the paint job all the way to the headstock. So when you look at the whole guitar, it's just, you know, just nicely done from headstock to tailpiece, or strap button, I should say. So I'm going to put this one down. I'm going to walk over here. I want to stand in the middle of my collection. And I want to thank you for watching this video. Hopefully you got to enjoy my diamond guitar collection. I'm sure there will be more in the future because I really do love the line and the people behind the line. It's a nice collection. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Leave your comment below. Let me know which one you like the most and why. If you like this video, subscribe for more like it. I'll leave you all off with one of those. Thank you. Rock on. We'll see you later.